Hello, my name is Chawar Abdullah Farah from London, originally from Somalia. I'm talking about my books now, books that I've created for the Somali children in schools all over the world, especially those English-speaking children. But they are all bilingual, Somali and English, and they all created for a need. When a need arises, I'm there to help and I'm there to work on it. So the first time I have been employed by the Department of Education in London, I found out that there were no resources for the refugee child, and I developed resources then. The first book I thought was going to help the child in the classroom was a dictionary. I felt that the Asian children around them already had input from their own teachers and had enough resources in the libraries. So this was the first book I developed, which is a dictionary that covers all the vocabulary that a child needs in primary school. Then came a critical moment that children were really losing their identity, thinking that everything Somali was funny and they were ashamed of it. And they even changed their names to suit the culture and thinking that they have to do that to be able to mesh in. But that was the opposite. And I thought that I had a role to play to convince the teachers to show the schools that these children need to have their culture valued, their language valued, and they should be taught in school. And I was lucky enough that we had assemblies for children, and the schools also asked me if I can translate the first week of Somali games, 108 Somali games in there, but that book is only in Somali. And they said, why don't you have it in English and do it in the schools? So in the schools that I was working, I translated the same book into English. And these children are children, international children, including Somalis, that were in the school and that I took part in photographing them and putting these stories into English. That's called Somali, that's action rhyme for children. I play that with my children, my grandchildren, and anyone who comes in contact with me, and it's very useful in schools. So those three books are the first three books developed as resources for the refugee child, no matter where they come from. I worked with any refugee child, Punjabi speakers, English, Arabic speakers, Japanese, I love them. So many children from different countries. This is a story, fiction story, a traditional fiction that whenever I write, I put my input, I change things, I add things, or I take away things. So anything that I think is not child-friendly, I delete it, I put my own idea in. Anything that I think that needs to be developed further, I do that as well. So this is a story about the house, how the sky was made. And it's the role that women take in educating their children when they're very young. And this is told by ritual, a story told by grandmothers. And it says that in the past, millions of years ago, people did not know about how the sky was made. But grandparents told children stories about what they thought or how they thought the sky was made. They thought that the sky was so low that the children standing on the floor could touch them with their fingers, poke them, or even have their heads through them. And then one day, there was all the women in the country decided to make a special feast. And they took out the mortar and pestle to pound and pound the Somali millet that breakfast is made of, our special pancake, anchelo, and they poked holes in the sky. And then the sky couldn't take the pain and went up, up, up until it stopped where it is today. The story is so long, I don't want to go into it, but that's the introduction bit of it. That's a Somali story that is the same as any folklore of the world, and it's quite compatible and suitable for children. This one here is for the life cycle of a child. Children quite like it, schools quite like it, because when we're teaching, we teach about the life cycle of a chicken or hen, the life cycle of a frog, and Somali children, when they come to school, they don't know about the life cycle. So I felt, well, we have it in our culture, we have it in our language. There's rich literature that we need to dig into and find out what we can teach our children before they even go to the school. They'll be prepared. And then when they have to sequence the life cycle of an animal or a human being, they will be able to do it as long as they read this book and know about it. So it's called The Life Cycle of a Somali Nomadic Child. And it starts off with Once I Was, which is Berry Banner. There, Once I Was, a teeny weeny one, a teeny weeny girl lying on a mat. And then in school, when we show this, we say, why would this baby be lying on a mat? We don't have cots. Our children in the nomadic society are not born in hospitals. So that's a stage where you can develop activities around the book. And then, once I learned to sit on my fat, fat bottom. They all laugh their heads off. They love it. So this is a suitable book for girls, nomadic girls. And then I thought, and I said, oh, people will be thinking what's happening to the boys. So in this book, I decided to make up my own section of the boy. And it's Once Upon a Time, I went toddling all around the camp. And there's the little boy toddling around. It's the same for the girl as well, but where they differ is here. Look at him, shaved. This is a camel boy. And it says, once I had a shaved head and walked briskly about. And there he is, going briskly about. And then he gets married. He starts looking after the camels. Once I was a camel boy looking after baby camels. And then, until he gets married. Once I was a big man, I was very handsome too. This is all my own invention. Once I enjoyed flirting about, but was ready to marry too. And then, once I was an alert and sensible bridegroom. Yeah. And then he becomes a father. Once I was a father of four. And a good father too. Once I was a father of five and a good storyteller. So that the boy incorporated into the culture of the Somalis, which labor is always divided between women and men. So I tried to put it together now and make sure that we're equal and boys enjoy the same sort of life that girls enjoy and girls enjoy the same sort of life that boys enjoy. But there's no cardinal division between the two. And this is, this one here is the last book I have written. I quite like it. It's a book about mum and how she brings up the baby. But in the nomadic society, the baby is being talked to. Our lullabies are not like the English lullabies, where the main idea is to make the child sleep. The main idea in the Somali culture is to prepare the child for life. So here, there's a CD in there. It is for boys and girls, and some of the songs I had to exclude it because they were a bit sexist, but in terms of here, it's sexist. In the nomadic life, it was real life. Boys look after camels, girls look after sheep and goats. And boys are away and men are away for many, many days, whereas the women are staying around the house and the animals that they look after are not ones that have to go a long distance away.